Hi friends, today's topic is data structures. So data structure means simply organization of data. Organization of data in a computer. Suppose if you have many number of information, that is lot of information, arranging all those information is generally very difficult task. Suppose if the entire information is placed as a group, it is not possible to retrieve a required element from the group. For that purpose, the entire information is arranged in some particular fashion for easy accessing. That is, in simple term, data structure is organization of data in a computer for effective access. For effective access or for effective operations. To implement the operations very effectively. Data structures is categorized into two types. So one is linear data structure, second one is non-linear data structure. So the name specifies linear data structure. The elements present in this are in sequential manner. Linear data structure means the elements are placed as a sequential manner, that is, the elements are organized in a sequential manner. Non-linear data structure, so here there is no need of non-sequential, simply the elements are placed at randomized fashion, that is, wherever the free memory location is available, at that memory location we are placing the elements. If we are placed the elements in sequential manner, if we are placed the elements in randomized manner. These are the two classifications of data structures, linear data, non-linear. Under linear, the different types of linear data structures are arrays, stacks, queues and linked list. So these are some of the examples of linear data structures. And under non-linear data structure, the examples are trees, graphs. These are the different examples. First, to coming to arrays. Simply, everyone know array is a linear data structure in which the elements are stored in sequential manner. That is, the entire elements, suppose this is an array. For example, in this location, first element of the array is stored. Compulsory in the second location, second element. For example, the address is 1000. If we are using integers, next element obviously 1002. This is 1004. So all the elements must be arranged in sequential manner. This is array. But array has some disadvantage. So disadvantage of array is fixed memory. That is, before using the memory, we have to declare how much amount of memory required by the program. That is, the memory is to be fixed, simply static. Array size is static. So to overcome this problem, we are going to linked list. That is, the linked list allocates the memory in dynamic fashion. Linked list memory is allocated in dynamic fashion. That is, through the process of execution, whenever it requires a memory, simply allocates the memory. But in array, at the starting of the program, we have to specify how much amount of memory we needed. In linked list, at the time of execution, we are specifying the memory requirement. And along with these two, we have two more linear data structures, stack and queue. So the purpose of stack and queue is, everyone knows stack. So if you don't know the technical term stack, but everyone knows the meaning of stack. Stack is last in, first out. Suppose we have some set of elements. If the set of elements are placed in this fashion, last in, first out. For example, plates on a dining table. If always last to plate, for example, this is plate 1, plate 2, plate 3, plate 4. We are placing the plates in this fashion. So last inserted means, suppose if anyone, a new person want a plate, he received plate 4. This is the last inserted element. So the elements are arranged in this fashion. So the last inserted element is the first removing element. Similarly, Q. Q means any railway queue or any bus queue or any queue. This is a normal queue operation. That is the first in, first out. Follows first in, first out. That is the first person who enters into the queue is the first person who releases from the queue. Stack is exactly reverse order. The first person who enters into the queue, he is the last person comes out. But in queue, the first person enters into the queue, he is the first person comes out of the queue. These are the different ways for arrangement of data. Here either stack, queue, arrays, linked list, all those represents organization of data. But similar to coming to non-linear data structure. Non-linear data structure, we have two types. So I already know trees and graphs. So some common point is trees and graphs is set of vertices. The vertices are connected through some edges. For example, this is a graph. 1, 2, 3, 4. For example, this is a graph. We have said set of vertices. That is, this set of elements. The elements are connected by using these edges. That is, we have an edge from node 1 to node 2. That is, from 1 we are moving to 2. From 2, we have three possible cases. From 2, either we have to move 1, 4, 3. So this is the organization of data in graphs. Similarly, suppose the tree represents 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For example, this is tree. In this tree also, nodes and corresponding edges, that is the path. So all those represents the organization of data. And the main difference between tree and graph is graph contains cycles. Graph contains cycles. Tree does not contain cycles. This is the very, very important. The graph contains cycles. Tree does not contain cycle. For example, cycle means we are starting at vertex 1. 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 5. Again, we reach from 1. That is, we are whenever vertex we are starting, finally if you reach to the starting vertex, that is a cycle. But in tree, we are starting at vertex 1, but we are not reached to vertex 1 after visiting all other vertices. Simply an acyclic graph is called tree. So these are the different data structures used in our programming and how we organize the data by using all these data structures.